Romulans. Joining me now is one of the legislators at that hearing, former senator and one-time presidential candidate, the one and only Mike Gravel, who represented the great state of Alaska for 22 years. Senator, welcome. What a pleasure it is to have you on Viewpoint.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you, sir. So let me start with the most obvious question. What got you involved in this particular hearing?
Well, I was approached. First off, I'm like any other citizen who's well-read. I followed the UFO, the ET issues casually. But I was approached 2 weeks ago if I would be part of this hearing. And I sort of blew it off because I didn't really understand what the hearing was about. I had other plans. But then another person who I had respect for briefed me more fully on what the hearing was about. And then I thought it would be an opportunity for me to spend 1 week, and of course preparation before the hearing, to become very knowledgeable about this subject, which is probably the most significant subject in our entire civilization, because it juxtaposes whether or not there's a force out there that we can identify with these sightings of saucers, you call it, whatever, and that force is observing the planet. And I've now, after the testimony and the research that I've done, I think that this hearing is extremely worthwhile, and there's no question about it that the government of the United States is in total denial of this. And of course, we've had several smoking guns to show that this denial is ridiculous.
Well, you're not the only one who thinks that, sir. And of course, I appreciate any Americans who go about investigating this. I think it is a significant issue that too often the media cynically writes off as just a joke. I'm wondering, is this common to have independent citizen groups invite former legislators to come and do a congressional-style hearing? And did your experience, sir, in the Senate serve you well in preparation for this?
Well, certainly my experience in the Senate did serve me well. And of course, the other five members of the House certainly add to it. So we all have, in fact, I think the number is it's about 80 years of legislative experience on our side of the table. But we're all retired from public office, and yet we're obviously citizens interested in the public issues involved. So it's the first knowledge I have. That's why I didn't understand initially of this kind of a format. The reason for the format was that the group that's putting it on is the Paradigm Research Group. They wanted to be able to see if they could shame the Congress, so to speak, into having a hearing like this. I personally don't think it's going to happen. I think the Congress is not going to be interested in a subject like this. There's no political benefit, and there's political risk involved. But there's a new direction that this should go in, and this should go in towards a global, because this is a global issue, not just an American issue. The American government is the one that's most irresponsible in handling the subject, but it's a global issue, and we should have the United Nations, the General Assembly, form an agency and have a global conference of scientists that would focus on the issues involved.
Sir, how specifically is the American government irresponsible in handling this issue?
Well, first off, you get the White House. Well, they don't know anything about it. There's nothing, and they don't have any files. Well, that's an outright lie, whether it comes from who in the White House or the president. And of course, what happens is all the way down the chain of command, they keep the cover up. Now, the cover up started with what happened in Roswell, where a spacecraft, flying saucer, what have you, crashed, and apparently there were four humanoids or whatever that died or perished in that event. And right after that happened, within hours, the general involved, the General Ramey, took charge of it and just began to shut everything down. It's classified, intimidating anybody and everybody that was involved, intimidating them and getting a lot of military personnel to sign non-disclosure agreements. Now, that's who we have been interviewing these last 3 days, and we got two more days to interview military personnel who were on the scene, who give direct first-hand testimony, and then the researchers and the scholars that have devoted their time and energy. So you got military personnel as high-ranking as lieutenant colonels and full bird colonels and scholars who are steeped in the field and who have written numerous books on the subject.
Well, Senator, I do appreciate you and your fellow legislators using your celebrity and renown to draw attention to this issue to pressure Congress to at least start talking about it. But I have to ask, are some of the other former Congress members just picking up a paycheck for this thing, or do you think they're genuinely concerned?
No, they're generally concerned. Well, first off, the paycheck, stop and think. It's five days. 9 to 5 every day. So it's not what you call a high salary situation. But they covered all the expenses, and it's just reasonable. You know, you get the pundits that go out and speak and get $30,000, $40,000, $50,000, or a Henry Kissinger who gets $100,000+ a speech, or Ronald Reagan who goes to Japan and gets, what, $2 million for one speech. So the money is incidental. Clearly, unless you're well endowed, and I'm not, and I don't think any of the other persons would be what I call wealthy. No, they're public citizens who have served and realized that this issue, and they came in very skeptically. Mm-hmm. There was nobody who was overwhelmingly convinced that this was a legitimate issue, and fearful of the issue, because, as you know, mainstream media, by and large, tries to marginalize people.
Yes,
and,
they do.
And call them a little kooky. And,
indeed,
well,
they
I was
do.
Interviewed right off the beginning, and a person said, well, Senator, tell us about the little green men. Mm-hmm. Well, I don't know any little green men. And it was demeaning, and I was able to bring the person around. Because what's at issue here is something we don't know, and that the government would cover it up. Now, we know why the government's covering it up, because we have several smoking guns. And I'll give you one of them as an example. With the missile silos in Montana, the Dakotas, and one other state, Wyoming, whenever there was one of these these call them flying saucers, for lack of a better word, hovering above the silo, the missiles were unlaunchable.
Yes, we mentioned that in our introduction to the segment.
Well, I'll tell you right off the bat, the military would go bonkers over that, because what it shows is that after spending $1 trillion on this unbelievable defense system, when push comes to shove, it doesn't work. Mm-hmm. So obviously, they want to keep that secret. But the nature of the military in this country and the nature of those in power, the leaders, is that they have a perception totally towards secrecy and to keep things covered up. And that's very sad, because if we're to be an operating democracy, the people have to know what's going on. And since this thing is of civilized, planetary import, the people of the world should know what's going on. Most countries have
Absolutely.
Been much more revealing on this subject, but the United States is the dark hole in this regard.
Well, sir, I'm sorry we're out of time for this, but it's a pleasure to have you talking about it, an issue many Americans care about. Former Senator Mike Gravel, thank you for talking to us. And I want to tell you what a pleasure it was watching you debate for president back in 2008.